Hello, hello, good evening.
Hi, teacher.
How are you today, my dear participants? It's good to see you again. Tonight, we are going to continue with section number 3. Okay, so welcome to Julie, welcome to Elizabeth and Juan Carlos Garcia. I hope that your classmates can join in a couple of minutes. But by now, we are going to start. Remember that today is Thursday. So this is our last day of class in this week. So we have completed the second week of class. So we are exactly in the half of the sections. So I expect that we can almost conclude section 3, and then that you can go to the platform tomorrow or during the weekend, and that you can advance at least to the level that we have advanced in class, okay? Very good. I'm going to share with you the part of the platform we are working tonight. So tonight it's a 3.7 lesson objective. Because the previous one are related to the class that I gave you last night, and those are about listening. The previous 3.6 is about listening, intonation. So that's where you have to go and listen and practice with the video. Okay, so tonight we are going to continue with 3.7 that says, in this session, a conversation will be played where a waiter and a customer use modal verbs such as would and will for request, okay? So we have been learning about modals, and we learn about modals for suggestion, but tonight we are going to learn about modal for request. And basically, we will be working with would and will, okay? So let's continue. In the platform, you have a video that says ordering a meal. And then you will listen to a conversation where a waiter and a client talk about the waiter offers different kinds of meal, and the client requests and asks for a specific meal. So I invite you to go to the platform and to listen and watch the video. But tonight I have a presentation for you. So I just want to advance. Okay, when you finish 3.7 and 3.8, you will be able to use the modal verbs would and will for request, okay? So there you have another verb, another video with would and will, okay? So you go to the platform. And finally, you will reach to the knowledge check, which is in 3.11, okay? So after this class, after tonight's class, you will be able to complete this section. And then you will listen an exercise, so this is a listening practice, to develop your skills, listening skills. Because in this, you need to pay attention and to listen once, twice, three times, four times, until you can clearly understand what they are talking about. So let's order. That's another listening exercise. And finally, you have listen to the conversations. And then after you listen to the conversation, you have to check the box that is correct, okay? So you listen and then you check. And then remember, this is the midterm. At this point, we are in the midterm, okay? So you have to put words in order. So that's the other part. You have to circle the correct word. Complete sentences with should, shouldn't, or can't. Remember that this topic we already studied, so you are able to do it. Finally, match the problem with the advice. Es como unir el problema con la recomendación o con la sugerencia. And the F section is complete the conversations with bottle, jar, pack, or tube. Okay. And G, read the article and then check the four things people suggested to write to writer should do. And that's it. I think that we then finish the midterm exam and then we go to lesson objective four. So that's what we have to advance, at least during this weekend. So next week we are going to work in lesson objective four in the complete fourth section, and then section five. Okay, but by now, let me go to section three and then go to the lesson objective for tonight. Okay, I just will go fast to the lesson objective of the pronunciation because this is only for you to practice. In this, in 3.6, as I was saying, you have this video that you need to watch. And then we go to modal verbs to request and also to offer. So would and will. So I will stop the platform here and then we go to the presentation I have for you. Okay, let me see. Okay, can you watch my screen? ¿Pueden ver mi plataforma, mi pantalla?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, very good.
Yes.
So, we have would like plus noun and would like to plus a verb, okay? So, the structure is when you request for something, you say, I would like a cup of tea. Me gustaría una taza de té. Or you say, you would like to drink tea. Te gustaría tomar té. She would like to drink a cup of coffee. Or she would like a cup of coffee. He would like to drink a tea. So those are affirmative sentences. And then they are used to request. But if I want to offer you something, then I move the would at the beginning of the sentence and I say, would you like a cup of tea? ¿Te gustaría una taza de té? Would you like to drink tea? ¿Te gustaría tomar té? Entonces, si usted se fija, la diferencia entre uno y otro es que cuando yo digo, would like a cup of tea, lo que sigue es un noun, un sustantivo. A cup of tea, una taza de té, ¿verdad? Pero cuando yo digo, would you like to, entonces lo que sigue después de to es un verbo, to drink, ¿ok? Entonces allí es, te gustaría tomar té, tomar en la bebida té, ¿verdad? Y tomar una taza de café. Ok, very good. So, when I want to say no, you say, thank you. Not yes, please, or yes, I would, or no, I wouldn't. But if you want to say a full answer, you say, I wouldn't like a cup of tea. Maybe you can say thank you at the beginning. Thank you, but I wouldn't like a cup of tea. I wouldn't like to drink tea. Okay, that's saying no in a full answer. But if you want to say just yes, see, you say yes, I would. Or yes, I would, yes, please. No, I wouldn't. Okay, so here I want to expand my screen because I want you to read this small letters, sorry. It says, I would like a cup of tea is a more polite way to say, I want a cup of tea. Si usted dice, I want a cup of tea, se oye como pesado, como poco diplomático, poco amable. Quiero té, así, quiero té, un poco pesado. Aquí usted diga, me gustaría una taza de té. Or, I would like to drink tea. O me gustaría tomar té, ¿verdad? When you say, I would like a cup of tea, etc., it's often contracted to I'd. Vean que el I would like, o el I would, ese would se puede contractar con I y el apóstrofe y la letra D. Cuando usted vea esto así, y seguidamente el verbo like, entonces estamos hablando de I would like, I would like. Y esto se dice I'd like a cup of tea. In speaking, this is only in speaking, because when you write in a, I don't know, in an email, in a letter, or in a document, you need to use the complete words. When you say, yes, I would, it's never contracted, yes, I. Esta es una prevención, ¿verdad? Tiene que decir de manera completa, yes, I would. No puede, es, en este caso, no se puede contractar con yes, I'd, eso no. No suena bien, ¿verdad? Y no lo toman como correcto. In response to an offer, you say, no, thank you. It's considered more polite. No, I wouldn't. Usted puede decir, no, gracias, como en español. Pero en inglés no se oye tan diplomático o tan amable. Usted debe decir mejor, no, I wouldn't. No, no me gustaría, gracias, ¿verdad? Okay. Now, I have here some food, okay? You say, would you like a burger? You can say, yes, please. Or no, thank you. Would you like a sausage? Yes, please. No, thank you. Would you like some chips? No, thank you. Or yes, please. Would you like some peas? No, thank you. Yes, please. Would you like some rice? Yes, please. No, thank you. Would you like some meat? Yes, please. Or no, thank you. Okay? So, before we go to this part, antes que vayamos a esta parte de contestar, I would like that you can look to the conversation that is in the platform. In the platform, you have a conversation between a waiter and a customer. And the waiter said, may I take your order? Vea que está usando may. ¿Puedo tomar su orden? Y la persona dice, yes, I like the lamb kebabs. All right, and would you like a salad? Yes, I'll have a mixed green salad. Okay, what kind of dressing would you like? We have blue cheese and vinaigrette. Blue cheese, please. And would you like anything to drink? Yes, I like a large iced tea, please. So, what we are going to do is that we are going to join in pairs and then we will perform this conversation or a similar conversation, but you have here extra food. So I will take a picture to this extra food and you can also imagine other type of foods that you would like to eat tonight. And then instead of saying maybe the names that are in the real, in the original conversation, you use this or you use your own meals. Puede utilizar en la conversación estas imágenes, ¿verdad? Que les estoy enviando ahorita. O pueden reemplazar por el nombre de una comida real, ¿verdad? Que a usted le gusta y que usted sepa cómo se dice. Okay, so what I want you to do is to perform a similar conversation like this one. So I will send you the picture also. Les voy a enviar la imagen también, ¿verdad? De esta. Me interesa más que el dibujo, el contenido. So I want you to practice. Me gustaría que practiquen. Entonces, teniendo los nombres de las comidas, la conversación, I will go to the breakout rooms. I will give you 4 minutes for you to practice. So you decide who will be the waiter and who will be the customer. And after 4 minutes, we will come back to the main room in order to perform the conversation in pairs. In some cases, maybe we'll have a trio, but I think no, because we are 9 with me. So you are going to be 8. So it means 14. Okay, let's see. Okay, I have already created the breakout room, so please go. Hello, my dear Arnold. Your partner is Miguel Flores.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. May I take your order?
Yes. I like the lamb kebabs.
All right. And would you like a salad?
Okay, and would you like anything?
Yes, I would like an ice cream, please.
Okay, what do you
Soda. Una agua de horchata.
Un fresco y chan.
Un fresco y chan.
Okay.
Okay.
Drink?
Yes. I will like iced tea.
Iced tea, okay. I take your order.
Okay.
I'll be back.
Okay.
Teacher, tiene mute. Teacher, no se escucha, teacher.
No le escuchamos, teacher.
Very good. Ready? Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Very good. Okay, very good. I'm waiting for your colleagues to come back. Creo que le voy a tener que cerrar el breakout rooms porque no están de regreso o sí están. No, no están. Los vamos a cerrar. Pero ya están cerrados.
Carlos, teacher.
Pero ya están cerrados. Ahí están ya. Hello, welcome back. Can you hear me?
Hello, teacher.
Okay, very good. Okay, someone was asking, what are kibbutz? Okay, so let me give you the definition. Okay, just let me see. I will share again. Vamos a compartir de nuevo la pantalla porque creo que se salió. Okay, very good. There you go. Okay, kebab. It says a dish of pieces of meat, fish or vegetable, roast or grill on a skewer or spit. Okay. Dice que es un plato de piezas de carne, ya sea de res, de pescado o de vegetales, rostizados, ¿verdad? O como a la parrilla, ¿verdad? Entonces son como las famosas fajitas. Algo así como las fajitas en español, ¿verdad? Vamos a ver. Sí, es justamente como un pincho o como fajitas, ¿verdad? Son piezas pequeñas con las que usted puede hacer un taco o puede hacer un, let's see, un pincho o fajitas. Ok, very good. You're welcome. Okay, my dears, are you ready to do your presentation? ¿Están listos para la presentación?
Okay.
Okay, who would like to start? ¿A quién le gustaría comenzar? Hello. Okay, Arnold. Hello, Arnold. Good to have you here back in class.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, good to have you here. Okay, who is your partner? ¿Con quién trabajó usted, Arnold?
No recuerdo cómo se llamaba.
¿No era Miguel?
Yo creo que sí, Miguel.
Okay.
Me.
Okay.
Hi.
Hi, okay. Okay, very good. Go ahead, adelante. You decide who is the waiter and who's the customer.
Okay. May I take your order?
Yes, I like the lamb kibbutz.
All right. And would you like a salad?
Okay, customer. Would you like a salad?
Yes. Yes. I'll have a mixed green salad.
Okay. What kind of dressing would you like? We have a blue cheese and vinaigrette.
Blue cheese, please.
And would you like anything to drink?
Yes. I like a large iced tea, please.
Okay, very good. Nice. Congratulations. Next team, please. Who else would like to continue? ¿A quién más le gustaría continuar de los equipos? Okay, Elizabeth, go ahead.
With Julie.
Okay, Elizabeth and Julie.
Julie, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so I start.
Okay, may I take your order?
Yes, I would like a burger, please.
You're right. And would you like some chips?
Yes, I'll have some chips. And also, I would like a green salad.
Okay. Oh. What kind of the ingredients in the salad?
I would like a salad with some tomato, avocado, and cucumber, please.
Okay. And would you like anything to drink?
Yes, I would like a light Coca-Cola, please.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, very good. Very fast food, but you included a salad. Very good. I like the way you innovate the conversation, and I like the way you say, I'm not blame. I'm eating hamburger, but also I'm eating a salad.
Yes, teacher.
I'll do it sometime. I must confess. Okay, very good. Thank you, ladies. Okay, next volunteer team. Who's ready? David?
Hi, teacher.
Hi, my dear. Good to have you here back in class. We were missing you.
Yes, I have a problem in the work.
I'm sorry to hear that. But it's good that you are back, okay? Whenever you can, you're welcome. And if you can't, you can listen to the audio, to the video. But okay. It's good. We are happy to have you here, okay?
Thanks,
okay,
teacher.
Okay, David, go ahead. Who was your partner?
It's Katia.
Okay, Katia. Are you ready, my dear?
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry.
Don't worry.
Okay.
Take your order.
Yes, I like the chunks.
All right. Would you like some chips?
Yes, I'll have a chips.
Okay. What kind of dressing would you like in your chunks? We have buffalo or chipotle. Mm-hmm. How do you say chipotle?
Yes, it's a very native name.
Okay.
Buffalo, please.
And would you like anything to drink?
Yes, I like large beer.
Oh, okay. Wow. Okay, chunks and beer. Okay, very good.
Okay.
Nice. A nice okay. Combination for tomorrow, Friday.
Yes. It's
okay.
Friday friends.
Friday friends. And some people say, and the body knows. Okay, thank you. Thank you, team.
Thank you.
Okay, let me see who's missing. Noé?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, who was your partner, Noé?
My partner is Miguel.
Okay, I'm sorry, Miguel. Okay, very good. I was confused with the other team. I'm sorry.
Don't worry.
Are you there, Miguel?
Okay, yes, aquí.
Okay, very good.
I'm there.
Who starts?
Go ahead, Miguel.
Okay. I take you order?
Yes, I like pizza.
All right. Would you like salad with your pizza?
No, thanks. I wouldn't. I would like garlic bread.
Oh.
Okay. What kind of dressing would you like? We have pepper and tomato salad.
I would like tomato soup.
And would you like anything to drink?
Yes, please. I would like some of iced tea.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Minute, nice. Congratulations. You innovate your conversation and you say you offer something, but your customer say no. I prefer, and he expresses what he really wanted to eat. Very good. Okay, congratulations to all teams. Now you know how to use would like to in order to request and to offer things. Okay, now I have here this exercise. So I want you to read carefully and I want you to voluntarily take at least one. Okay, number one says, I'm thirsty. I would like a glass of water. Remember that in here, the instruction says, study the above boxes, the ones that I already told you, okay? Would like plus a noun, would like to plus a verb, and then complete the sentences. So it means that you can find I would like or I would like to, and then a verb. Okay, so check it out, and voluntarily I want you to please choose one and tell me what do you think could be the answer for each one. Okay, Elizabeth?
Number two.
Okay, tell me.
Would you like a break?
Yes. Okay.
We would like.
Would you? And then like. Okay. In this case, it's correct because a break is a noun. It's not a verb, okay? So we don't have to add to. It's just, would you like?
Oh, would you like?
No, está bien. Oh, está okay. Bien. Sí, está bien. Es correcto. Nada más les estaba haciendo la aclaración de que es correcto porque lo que sigue es, no es un verbo, sino un noun.
Yeah.
Por tanto, no debe de llevar el tú, ¿verdad? Okay.
Yeah.
Very good. And the magical word, please. Okay, thank you, Elizabeth. Okay, number three. Who would like to do number three?
Me, teacher.
Okay, Julie, go ahead.
I don't understand this. I would like some help with my homework.
Okay, so in this case, it's only would like, right? Because when you say some help is a noun. It's not a verb. Okay, very good. Number four. Thank you, Julie.
Okay.
Me.
Okay, Katia, tell me.
Patrick would like to go to the supermarket. He needs milk.
Okay, very good. In this case, we need to add the two because the next word after is go. So go is a verb. Very good. Thank you, Katia. Okay, number five. Volunteer for number five.
Will Tom like come with us?
Okay. Okay, very good. So it's would and then Tom like, and after like we add two, right? Because the next word is come. Come is a verb. And then, yes, he would. Very good. Okay, volunteer, please, for number six.
Me, teacher.
Okay, David.
Can I help you? Yes,
I would like a ticket to Melbourne.
Ticket to Melbourne.
Very good. It's only would like because a ticket is a noun. So we don't need to use to. So it's correct. I would like.
Okay. I would like.
Very good. Number seven. Volunteer for number seven.
Me, teacher.
Okay, Julie.
My friends would like to come to the party next week.
Very good. Okay, come is a verb. So we need to say would like to. Would like to come to the party next week. Very good. Thank you, Julie. Okay, another volunteer, maybe from the people that has not participated yet with this exercise?
Me, teacher.
Okay, Miguel, tell me.
Would you like to work on Saturday? Okay. No, I wouldn't.
Okay, very good. No. I think nobody would like, right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, would you like to work on Saturday? No, I wouldn't. Very good. So here we just add the negative part. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Miguel. I don't know if Juan Carlos would like to do one exercise of this.
Okay, teacher.
Number nine. Number nine, very good.
Would you like chocolate ice cream or vanilla ice cream?
Very good. Nice. Chocolate is a noun, so we don't have to use two. Okay? Thank you. Thank you, Juan Carlos. Okay, volunteer for number 10.
Me, teacher.
Okay.
Would you like to see a movie? No, I wouldn't.
Okay, thank you. In this case, it's would like to, right? Would yes. you like to? Because see is a verb. So in this case, verb. It's correct. Would you like to see a movie? No, I wouldn't. Okay, very good. 11, Elizabeth.
What would you like to do tomorrow?
Okay, very good. That's a very good question. What would you like to do tomorrow? In this case, we use like to because do is a verb, okay? And then what would you like to do tomorrow? Thank you very much. The last one, number 12. Who would like to finish this exercise?
Who would you like some candy?
Okay, very good. In this case, it's who would like? Who would like?
Who would like?
Yes. ¿A quién le gustaría? Porque no hay un... Cuando yo digo who, no hay alguien definido. Es como que yo entro al lugar y llevo uno dulce, ¿verdad? Y hay varias personas. O como que yo entro aquí a la clase y les digo, who would like some candy? ¿A quién le gustaría dulces? Entonces, no sé exactamente a quién, pero yo llego preguntando. Entonces, es who would like, nada más. No lleva sujeto porque es una WH question, ¿verdad? Who would like some candy? Entonces, aquí sí ya es como que ustedes todos me dijeran, we would.
We would.
Sí, no, es como, sí, ¿verdad? Nos gustaría, queremos, ¿verdad? Entonces, la respuesta sería, we would.
We would.
Very good. Okay, congratulations, team. Now you know how to complete an exercise, a written exercise about would like. Okay, so teacher, now, yeah, tell me.
Sorry, puede regresar a la número ahí, en la número 8, donde dice, would you like to work on.
Ah, third? Sí, aquí me comí el tú, perdón, ahí está. Yo, it's my fault, it's my fault, y, I forgot.
Y otra cosa, donde dice no, I wouldn't. Si yo quisiera decir no tampoco, yo tampoco solo diría neither am I.
Sí, así como well, ayer.
I'm not either.
Pero lo que pasa es que, fíjense que no. Porque lo que pasa es que el neither, either era cuando usted estaba secundando una...
Ajá.
Una oración negativa. Supóngase que usted dijo, alguien le preguntó, usted está en pareja, está con alguien, y llega un waiter, un mesero, o alguien que anda atendiendo en la fiesta y le pregunta, would you like to drink wine? ¿Le gustaría tomar vino? Usted dice, no, I wouldn't. Y su pareja, la persona con la que usted está conversando, dice, neither do I. Yo tampoco, ¿verdad? Porque ya usted dijo que no. Entonces la otra persona está secundando el no suyo. Pero usted de entrada en este tipo de oración no puede responder neither do I o me neither. ¿Por qué? No ha habido un antecedente de negación previo. Solamente así, de que alguien llegue, le ofrece y usted dice, no, I wouldn't. Y la persona que está a la par suya también afirma, afirma el no sin que le pregunten. Dice, neither do I, thank you. No, yo tampoco, gracias, ¿verdad? ¿Sí? Okay. ¿Is it clear? Yes.
Yes.
Okay, very good. So, you're welcome. So, we are going to continue now because we have been working with what would, ¿verdad? Or would. Would you? In this case, we have here the difference between are you. When we are taking an order, we can use also are you. Quiero aclararles esto porque como estamos en el contexto de tomar órdenes, ¿verdad? De comida. También estas son otras expresiones, aunque hemos estado hablando más de would you like or would you. También en algunos casos ustedes se van a encontrar con are you. Are you ready to take the order? Vean esta conversación. Are you ready to take the order? Y la persona le dice, I'll start with salad. Voy a comenzar con una ensalada. What would you like to order? Otra vez, ¿verdad? En el primero, ¿está listo para ordenar? En el segundo, what would you like to order? ¿Qué le gustaría ordenar? I'd like to have seafood sukiyaki. I'd like, recuerden que ese I es I would, ¿verdad? I'd like to have seafood sukiyaki. Would. Este would es como para continuar con la orden, ¿verdad? Would you like soup or salad with that? ¿Le gustaría sopa o ensalada con eso? I think I'll have soup. Okay. Would you like anything for this for dessert? I'd like to have ice cream. Okay. Vean cómo hemos utilizado, ¿verdad? Comenzamos con are you ready to order? What would you like to order? ¿Verdad? Would you like y ahí ya le ofrecemos cosas más concretas, ¿verdad? Y luego cerramos. Would you like anything for dessert? Okay. So, here, I just have some minutes. Okay. If we have the chance, we are going to perform a similar one. But by now, I would like that you can observe these sentences and you can tell me what would be the right answer. I would like travel to Spain next summer, but I don't have enough money. Or I would like to travel to Spain next summer, but I don't have enough money. And so on. I would like that you can look at the sentences and voluntarily you can choose one and tell me the right answer. Okay, Elizabeth?
Okay. I would like to travel to Spain next summer, but I don't have enough money.
Very good. Would like to. En ese caso, would like to, ¿verdad? Porque, porque estamos usando la siguiente palabra. ¿Verdad? Es precisamente un verbo. Entonces, ahí sí tenemos que utilizar el would like to. Creo que escogí una flecha en lugar de un arrow. An arrow instead of a line. Escogí una flecha en lugar de un...
Yes.
Ok, let's think about number two. Pensemos en la número dos. David.
Would you like to see an action movie tomorrow night?
Okay, very good. Would you like to see?
To see.
Right. In this case, it's letter B, right?
Letter B. Letter
okay,
B.
Very good. Number three, volunteer for number three.
Me.
Okay, Katia.
Are you ready to order? Yes. I would like a sandwich, please.
Okay, in this case, letter A, right?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Number four, volunteer for number four.
Maybe here.
Okay, Julie?
I'm bored. What you like to do this weekend.
Okay, I'm bored. I'm bored.
I'm bored.
What would you?
Would you?
Recuerden que en el este would la L no suena, ¿verdad? Es would. Mm-hmm. Would. Very good. So then is letter, excuse me, letter A or B?
B.
Okay, very good. Because we are saying, what would you like to do this weekend? Mm-hmm. Okay, great. Number 10?
Me, teacher.
Okay, go ahead.
Number 10. Which would you like, strawberry or vanilla ice cream?
Would you like, which would you,
Letter A.
Letter A, okay, very good, nice, correct, because strawberry is not a verb, it's a noun.
Yes.
Okay, number 11, thank you. Volunteer for number 11.
Me, teacher.
Okay.
Me, teacher.
Go ahead, okay.
Would you like to drink some tea? Yes, I would. Thank you.
Very good.
Number B.
Letter B. Very good. Because
tea, letter B.
Because B is, because drink is a verb. Okay, very good. Number 12. Okay. Let's see, Elizabeth and David. Okay, David, and then Elizabeth.
Okay. Hello. Hello. I would like to speak to Sarah, please.
Okay, very good. It's when you are in a phone call, right? Looking for someone. Yes. Okay, yes. Thank you, David. And speak is a verb, so we need to use two. Okay, Elizabeth?
Are you ready to order?
Yes, I would like to try the garden salad.
Okay, very good. I would like to try. Me gustaría probar, ¿verdad? Ese try es probar. Very good. Thank you. Thank you, my dears. Let me see if we have more. Yes, we have more. Sorry, but we have more. Another set of volunteers. Necesito otra vez. Voluntarios. To complete number 5.
Me, teacher.
Okay.
How many chocolate chips cookie would you like?
It's, okay.
Letter A.
Letter A, because we don't have a verb, ¿verdad? Termina la oración y no tenemos un verbo a la par. Okay, very good. Next, number 6.
Me.
Okay, Katia.
Would your kids like to play at the park next weekend?
Okay.
Letter B.
Letter B, because play is a verb, right? Okay, thank you, Katia. Number 7. Okay, volunteer for number 7.
Me, teacher.
Okay.
Would you like a coffee or tea? Okay. Yes, I would. Thank you.
Very good. So it could be, would you like a cup of
number tea? A.
Letter A. Very good. Thank you. Yes, I would. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much. Next volunteer, number 8.
Me, teacher.
Me, teacher.
Okay. Julie and then Roca Miguel. Okay.
Yes.
Very good. Okay. Julie.
Okay. I feel sick, so I wouldn't like to go home.
Sería I would like to, porque si dice wouldn't, no me gusta el negativo, pero como dice que se siente enferma, se quiere ir a casa temprano hoy. So I would like to. Very good. Thank you, Julie. Miguel?
Hello? Jim say he would like to cook dinner for us this evening.
This evening?
Letter B. This evening.
Very good. Yes, because cook is a verb. Thank you. Okay, volunteer for number 15.
Me,
David?
Teacher.
Okay, David, go ahead.
Which restaurant would you like to go to tonight?
Very good. So it's letter?
Letter B.
Very good. Vean ese que interesante. Which restaurant would you go to tonight? ¿Verdad? Would you like to go to tonight? Se oye unidito, ¿verdad? Pero es así. Ok, number 16, volunteer.
Me.
Sorry, moví todo, perdón. I'm sorry. Okay, Katia.
Can I help you? Yes, I would like to buy a hat.
Okay, very good.
Letter B.
Letter B, because buy is a verb. Okay, and the last one.
Me, teacher.
Okay, Noel.
What kind of present would you like for your birthday?
Mm-hmm. So it's A or B?
Letter A.
Very good. Because you is, for is not a verb. So we don't need to. Okay, very good. Now you have clear when to use would you like and would you like to. Very good. So here I have some examples using will. Will is also, will can have two functions. Will is a verb that expresses future. For example, I will travel to Europe next year. Okay? Es un futuro en cierta medida un tanto incierto, puede quedarse a nivel de deseo. Will. Will acompaña a un verbo principal. En este caso, will se vuelve un auxiliar para expresar futuro, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, vean esta. I'll give you a call on Monday. Es una promesa. Te daré una llamada el lunes, ¿verdad? Es un futuro un tanto incierto porque puede que me llame, puede que no. I'll take these books with me. Instant decision. Es para una decisión instantánea. Me voy a llevar estos libros conmigo. We'll book your tickets if you like. Es una oferta, ¿verdad? Te reservaremos los tickets si tú quieres. Estoy ofreciendo. Es como si le hubiera preguntado, would you like, we book your tickets? Pero no, le dice, we'll book your tickets if you like. Es como de una vez le digo, te reservaremos los tickets si tú quieres. No es una pregunta, vean. Solo es una afirmación, pero le da la oportunidad de decir, ¿quiere o no quiere? We will see an increase in salaries next year. Vean, es una predicción, digamos, medianamente certera. Would you mind if I open the window? Está pidiendo permiso. ¿No te molestaría si abro la ventana? Would you make me a coffee? Es un request, una solicitud. ¿Me harías un café? ¿O me podrías hacer un café? Would you be available at 6 p.m. tonight? It's making arrangements, para hacer arreglos, ¿verdad? ¿Estaría disponible a las 6 p.m. esta noche? Would you like to go out sometime? Es una invitación, ¿verdad? ¿Te gustaría salir alguna vez? Would you prefer the window seat or the aisle? Or the aisle, preferences. ¿Te gustaría el asiento de la ventana o el de a un lado? Okay, and shall, it's a certain of future, asking what to do. Offer or suggestion, right? Shall is similar to will, very similar. Should, ought to, and must, we already started. So I won't go deep. And because of the time, I'm going to stop the class here, but I will send you the material for you to continue studying at home. But I would like you to please go to the platform and advance and complete the whole section number 3. Okay, questions until here? ¿Preguntas hasta aquí? Yo les voy a mandar el material, ¿verdad? Para que lo revisen en casita y les pediría que por favor avancemos completando todos los ejercicios de la sección número 3. ¿Preguntas? No questions?
No questions.
Okay, very good. I hope to see you on Monday. Have a nice weekend. Remember that tomorrow is free. So please be safe and take advantage to study, okay?
Okay.
Very good. See you. Bye-bye.
Have a nice weekend.
Same for you.